Good morning, students. In our previous video, we have studied many properties of water. Using those properties, we can use water in different field, such as what fluidity. First one is fluidity. Water is useful for water transport due to its fluidity property. Water is useful for water transport due to its fluidity property. That is, in water cargo, ship carrying passengers, etc. Water falling down from a height is used to generate electricity. Water falling down from a height is used to generate electricity with the help of a generator. Second, water as a good coolant. Water as a good coolant and is used in motor vehicle to control the temperature of the engine. Water is used in motor vehicle to control the temperature of the engine. We can cool down the engine. Water as a good coolant. Third, water as a universal solvent. Many substances are soluble in water. Many substances are soluble in water. So, water is a universal solvent. Water is used as a solvent in factories, laboratories, foodstuffs, and in various types of biological process occurring in the body, such as digestion, excretion, etc. Fourth, water as a cleaning agent. Water as a cleaning agent. Water is useful for cleaning purposes such as for bathing, washing clothes, washing utensils, etc. These are the uses of water according to its properties. Now we move to soil and its properties. Soil and its properties. What is meant by soil? How is formed? Soil makes land. Soil makes land. The process of soil formation takes place at a very slow pace. It is a natural process in which heat, cold, and rainwater cause weathering of the bedrock. Weathering of the bedrock. The weathering forms stones, sand, smaller particles of soil, etc. Because of the weathering, form stone, sand, smaller particles of soil, etc. from the original rock. And microbes, worms, insects, and rodents are also act as weathering agents. They are also weathering agents. In this way, soil is continuously and slowly formed. Now, what are the ingredients in soil? What are the ingredients of soil? Soil contains two type of constituents, that is abiotic and biotic constituents. In abiotic constituents, smaller particles, sand, rock, stones, etc. are present. In biotic constituents, worms, insects, rodents, and microbes are present. This way, abiotic and biotic constituents are present in soil. Now we move to properties of soil. In that, first property is color. The soil gets its color as a result of several processes. The color of particular land is dependent upon the soil color. Color of soil near the land surface is darker than the color of the lower layers. Which are the colors of soil? Black, red, copper color, yellow color, and gray color. These are the different colors of the soil. Classification of the land is done from the colors of soil. According to the color, they are classified. Properties of land are also dependent on the color of soil present there. Even properties of land are also dependent on the color. Properties of the soil such as fertility, drainage of water, capacity to hold water depend on its color. Fertility, drainage of water, and capacity to hold water, they all depend on its color. The color of the soil is depend upon its texture and organic ingredients and also chemical ingredients. Which are chemical ingredients? Like contents of iron and lime. This is about the first property. Now we move to second property. Yes, before going to the second property, we have to observe one activity. For that, we have to take 3 measuring cylinder, 3 glass funnel, filter paper, water, fine sand, coarse sand, soil from an earthen pot used for growing plants. These are the things you have to take first. Then, fit cones of the filter paper. Make cones of the filter paper in the 3 glass funnel. Fit the cone in the glass funnel. Then, fill the cones with the equal quantities of sand, that we have to take it in A measuring cylinder. Then B is sandy soil, C is clay. Then place the funnel on the measuring cylinders. Pour 1 test tube of water. Now we have to pour 1 test tube of water into each of the funnel. Then observe how much water is collected in each of the measuring cylinder. We will observe that the water collected in sand is more than sandy soil. And water collected in sandy soil is more than clay soil. From this observation, we can conclude that the water holding capacity of clay is more than sand. So this is the activity and inference concluded. Next property is, that is second property, that is soil texture. The soil texture depends upon by the proportion of particles of the various sizes in it. Soil texture depends upon by the proportion of particles of the various sizes in it. According to the texture of soil, the types of soil are identified. Which are the types of soil? First is sandy soil. Then second is silt soil. Third is clay soil. What are the differences between them? The proportion of large particles of sand is more where in sandy soil. In sandy soil, the proportion of large particles of sand is more. In silt soil, the particles are of medium size. Particles are of medium size in silt soil. In clay soil, the proportion of small particles is maximum. Second point. Through sandy soil, water drains rapidly. Through sandy soil, water drains rapidly. In silt soil, it is not easily ployable. It is not easily ployable. In clay soil, it is difficult to plow the clay soil. Third point. In sandy soil, plowing of this soil is easy. Plowing is easy, but soil is less fertile. In silt soil, contains large proportion of organic materials. It contains large proportion of organic materials. The particles of clay soil are smooth to touch. It is smooth to touch. Fourth differences. Particles are in sandy soil. Particles are made of the silicon dioxide, that is quartz. In silt soil, good capacity to supply nutrients, also called sedimentary soil. In clay soil, has a high water holding capacity. Now, in sandy soil, particles are insoluble in water. Therefore, soil supplies less nutrients. These are the differences between sandy soil, silt soil and clay soil. And this differences between is important also for your exam point of view. So, note down, it will come in difference between. The third property of soil is soil structure. Structure of soil occurs in the form of columnar, laminar, granular as well as block shaped structures. Yes, which are they? Columnar, laminar, granular and block shaped structure. This structure depends upon the different shapes of the particles in it. This structure is depends upon the different shapes of the particles in it. The fertility of soil depends upon soil structure. Fertility is depends upon soil structure. The advantages of good soil structure are: roots are supplied with a good amount of oxygen, good water drainage, good growth of plant roots. This is the advantages of good soil structure. Now we will go to uses of soil in our next video. Thank you.